will go to a server. If there are n number of links, a request will go to a server for each clicks. Okay, so that means there are n number of requests going to each page. A book, say for example, a book consists of say 5 pages, and each page will direct to one link. Now when I'm clicking on a first link, a request will go to a server to read the contents of the first page. Okay, similarly, when I click on a second link, a request again will go to a server to read the contents of the second page. Like this, if there are 5 pages, so 5 requests will go to a server. That means you are creating 5 requests which will be built into a server. Okay, an application, a traditional web applications, you will not have any idea that what would be the next link. Okay, so this can be termed as a fetch demand. So when the user through his or her actions tell the server what data should be retrieved. Okay, so it is very unfortunate that to open each page, a request has to be sent to a server. So that means since there will be a lot of requests going from each page to a server, there will be a lot of burden on the server. How do we overcome this? So Ajax gives a solution for this. Okay, so what is that solution? The predictive fetch pattern is very, very simple. When you are reading the contents of a first page, automatically in the background, a request should go to a server to download the contents of the second page. When you start finishing reading the contents of the first page, automatically the second page content should be displayed, so that you should not feel as a user that contents should be downloaded from the server to read the contents of the second page. Similarly, when you start finishing the reading the contents of the second page, okay, during this time, okay, so a request has to go to a server to download the contents of a third page. So like this, so you are reducing a delay or a gap for the request and responses to read the contents of a web page. Okay, so Ajax application guesses what the user is going to do next and retrieves the appropriate data at appropriate time. Okay, so that means it is going to record what actions the user is doing it. Say a simple example, even the Amazon website is based on this Ajax application. Of course, it has also implemented some machine learning algorithms, but at a very basic level, the web applications of Amazon is based on Ajax. So determining the future user action is like guessing a game depending upon the intentions of the user. Now see, for example, you are downloading some videos, okay, or say some audio songs, etc. So when you are downloading one audio songs, if there are series of audio songs which are available in your links, so when you're clicking on one audio song, so in the background as a request for downloading the second audio song should also go. So this can happen only if the application is developed in Ajax. Otherwise, in traditional applications, it is not possible to do it. Okay, I would like to assume one more example for this. Suppose you are reading an online article that is separated into 3 pages. It is logical to assume that if you are reading the first page, you are also interested in reading the second and the third page. So if the first page has been downloaded for a few seconds, okay, so it is probably safe to download the second page in the background. So when you are reading the second page, it is also probable that you can also read the third page. Okay, if the second page is loaded for few seconds, Okay, then there is also probability that a reader will continue on the third page. Okay, so this is the request which is being sent dynamically from the Ajax application server, and this will be cached at the client. If you remember the Ajax application model, so I have showcased one component called as Ajax engine, which basically does a background work. Okay, so in the background work, okay, so this pages keeps downloading and it will be cached on the the client. So, and the user barely notices that some page is coming instantaneously after clicking on next page link. But as a user, that we think that every time when we click on the link request will go to a server, so it will process and gives back the results. So this happens in typically in Ajax, in traditional web applications. In Ajax applications, okay, so the consecutive links or subsequent links will be automatically downloaded, assume depending upon the user actions. So this is a very interesting feature. The advantage of using this is a time delay is drastically reduced to get the response from the server for the request made by the client. This is the second example. And even the third example, one more example I just wanted to tell you. See, another simple example with respect to your email. Okay, see, suppose say I'm frequently sending mails to some persons. Okay, like say assume, so I'm sending mails to say Rajesh, Avinash, okay, then Suresh, etc. Okay, so whenever I am sending a mail to Rajesh, okay, so I will be sending mail to Avinash and Suresh also. That means the application can understand when you are typing some contents to be sent to Rajesh, automatically you can see the name of Avinash and Suresh also. Okay, so this is done by using a Ajax application, and this happens in the background. So it makes your application feel very lighter and more responsive. Okay, so you can quickly overload your server and make the browser without extra processing. Okay, so it is logical to assume that the information will be requisite for completing the user's request. Okay, see, now as I told that whenever I'm sending a mail to Rajesh, okay, so it will show the names of say Suresh and Avinash logically. How does the application know about it? Because application catch that data which is there in the Gmail. But probably when I'm sending a mail to Avinash, okay, so Rajesh and Suresh, I might not send that specific information to these two people. But only when I'm sending a mail to Rajesh, I will make sure that a mail will also go to say Suresh and Avinash. Okay, so this is an example of predictive fetch. The objective here is, okay, so depending upon the user's action, the application can guess, okay, what page will come next, or to whom mail has to be sent, and how it has to be read, and how it has to be projected. So this information can be sought in the XML HTTP request. See, each of this request has to be done programmatically. Okay, That means each of this request will be stored as objects in the XHTML, XML HTTP request. So every time, so when the request is being sent, the objects are created, I mean to say instance of that class will be created, and every time it checks whether the ready state change is 4, okay, and status is okay. So this keeps in loop until and unless all the actions is being it is being completed. Okay, so the objective of predictive fetch is to understand the request and responses from the client and server depending upon the user action. One second thing is reducing the time delay for the request and responses. Third is to have a logical understanding for the requests by the client. Okay, this is what you have to know about a predictive fetch. Since the programming concepts in this case is out of the, you know, the syllabus, but anyway, I will just try to write a simple program, okay, and showcase it to you in my next applications. You can know how this predictive fetch pattern can be used, okay, in using an Ajax. Okay, so if you have any kind of clarifications, please let me know. Any clarifications, predictive fetch? Okay. If you don't have any kind of clarifications, I will just go to submission throttling. Okay. What is submission throttling? I have discussed about a predictive fetch pattern, okay, which has got two functionalities. One is the retrieving the data from the server through the client, and the other side of the application is sending the data to a server. Okay, since you want to avoid page refreshes, the question is when the user data is important to be sent. In a traditional website or web application, each click makes a request to a server so that the server is aware of what the client is doing. In Ajax model, the user acts with the site or application without additional request being generated for each click. Okay, so one solution. So what is the meaning of this throttling? Okay, within a short span of time, maybe say 2 minutes, 3 minutes, or maybe say 5 minutes maximum, if you are clicking, or if you are doing 100 clicks, okay, there are possibility that application may crash, the server might be down, or connection might be timed out, or you may not be able to access the any of this informations which you have requested for, because parallelly multiple requests keeps on going to a server. Okay, so how do we do this? Okay, say for example, in a text box, I want to find there is a data, assume an example. So there is a database which will consist of n number of names. Okay, so I want to search a name by name Avinash so that I can get the required information. Now, you know the spelling of Avinash is A-V-I-N-A-S-H. Now, I am typing A. When I type A in the text box, it will show me all the names in the database or in the server starting with A. Like this, then there might be thousands of names. Okay. Next, what I will do, so now when I write a single character A, a request will go to a server to display all the names starting with A. That is the first request. Next, I type V. Next, it will show again AV will be a second request. The second request AV again will go to a server and it will show all the names starting with AV. Again, I will just type after V, I type I. So that will be a third request, AVI. So AVI will be a new request which will be sent to a client. Again, it will show me the list of all names starting with AVI. Okay, similarly for other characters. So AVINASH, 7. That means I am sending 7 requests to a client, to a server to know the information, something about server. Okay, so this is not the feasible way of doing this search. So this concept is not supported by, okay, so this concept is not supported by the traditional web application. The problem with this kind of an approach that it has to create a large number of requests in a short amount of time, okay, which not only may cause the problem for the server, okay, but also cause the user interface to slow down as each request is being made and processed. So what is the alternative now? The alternative is submission throttling. Okay, this submission throttling design pattern is an alternative approach to this kind of problematic scenario. Okay, then what we can do with submission throttling? This submission throttling, you are going to buffer the data to be sent onto a client, okay, and send that data at predetermined times. So what do you mean by that? Okay, sending the data to a server on the client at predetermined times means what? Okay, so that means now I don't want to send a request to a client only if I just type, say, letter A, or if I just type V, or if I just type I. Okay, I want to send a request to find out the information Abhinash only when I write, say, minimum five characters when I write. Okay, then the request should go to a server, otherwise it should not go to a server. Okay, so I don't want to send the request after each character is typed. Instead, the server will wait for a certain amount of time and send all this data currently, which is a text box. That means instead of sending the character A to a server, then characters AV to a server, then characters AVI to a server, instead of that, only if I type minimum 5 characters, so those 5 characters can be sent as one request to a server rather than sending each character as a request. So I will tell to a server, you take the information from the client only when I type 5 characters. Now, instead of sending seven requests, I'll be sending only one request. Okay, this delay from typing to sending is fine-tuned in the AJAX applications by using concept. So, a submission throttling typically begins when the website or the application first loads, okay, or maybe based on the user actions. Then the client side function is called to begin the buffering of data. Okay, that means a code would have been written in such a way that depending upon the user action. Now, what is that user action? So I want server to give me a response if only 5 characters is entered in the text box. Okay, So then once that is done, the client side function is called to begin the buffering of data. So every time a user status is checked, okay, every time the user status is checked. So if he or she is idle, okay, why we do this? So this is to prevent any kind of interference with the user's interface. Okay, so a user status can be idle or user status can be a busy. If the user is active, okay, data continues to be collected. See, this is another way of interpreting it. Okay, so if the user is active, data continues to be collected. What is this data? Data is the characters that I am going to enter in a text field. What are those characters? I can enter A, I can enter V, I can enter I, N, like this. Okay, this is the data what I mean to say. When the user is idle, that means he is not typing any kind of characters in a text box or is not performing any kind of action, then I can write a code in such a way that if I am not writing any characters or if I am not typing any characters in the in the text box, say for a minute or two, then that can be taken as a request to be sent to a client. So that means that information buffer. So one possibility is without entering say minimum 5 characters, I don't want to send the request to a server. Second thing is, if I'm idle for say 2 minutes or 3 minutes, okay, so I can send the information if I'm not performing any actions. So now I enter 5 characters and I'm not going to enter any more characters. Okay, then that information will be buffered and it will be sent to a server. Now this is the time to send decide whether to send the data or not. So this determination varies depending on the different cases. Okay, so as I said, you may want to send the data only when it reaches to certain size in the sense, okay, maybe 5 characters or 10 characters or something like that. Or I may want to send the data every time when the user is idle. Okay, so after the data is sent, the AJAX application typically continues to gather all the data, okay, and it sends as a server request to a server, okay, to stop the data collections, okay, so that the server can process the data and satisfies the user requirement. Okay, so this is about a submission throttling. So what is the difference of using a predictive fetch and sub-throttling? Sub-throttling is a later concept of predictive fetch, or you may also submission throttling is the advanced concept of predictive fetch. So the advantage of submission throttling is that instead of sending n number of requests to a server for within a short span of time, okay, so I can buffer the data and send it as one request to a server. Okay, so that is that. So when the time is very important, okay, you can use the concept of submission throttling. Okay, next, the submission throttling should never be used for mission critical data. Okay, that means very important information, you should not use it. Okay, if the information will be posted to a server, okay, within the specific amount of time, then it is better you can use a traditional form to ensure the correct and timely delivery of the information. Okay, so this is the concept of submission throttling. So any clarifications in this? Amit, any clarifications?
No, sir.
Okay, there are only two important questions in the in this concept. Write short notes on predictive fetch, and write short notes on submission throttling. Okay, so this will be only two questions in this things. So have another only two concepts to complete the portions of Ajax. Okay, so one is your fallback pattern and using array of XML HTTP request. Okay, so I will just try to write a program to showcase the practical example of using this predictive fetch and submission throttling in my next classes after completion of your internals. We'll see how this works actually. Okay. Just a moment, I want to showcase us with respect to some other thing. All of you are able to see my screen? Are you able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, you know, from next Monday and Wednesday, you have, you know, the lab exams. Okay. Lab internals. So I've just done a small application, to conduct lab examination. Okay, now see the interface will be something like this. This probably I will be deploying it in the server. Okay, so that you know, you can click against your names and you can, you know, generate the questions. Okay, now see, first on Monday's batch, I will be adding all the students' names. Those are coming in batch 3, batch 4. And for Wednesday's batch, I'm demonstrating say batch 1 and batch 2. Now, out of say 9 programs, you will be having 7 programs. Okay, so you'll not be having a second program on the 9th program. Okay, now here you are seeing 3 buttons. Okay, so student 1, student 2, student 3. So this will be replaced with the student name. Okay, so I will give you a provision, okay, so where you can click on your name. Okay, so when you click on the your names, okay, so you can just click here. Okay, you can see a question will be displayed in the dialog box. This is completely based on randomness. So what I did is I have put 7 questions in my array. Okay, and every time when you just, you know, when you press a name, okay, so you are going to get a, see here you can see earlier you had a function ajax. Now you have a write PHP program to demonstrate say predictive fetch. So again, you are clicking, okay, you are getting a different questions. Okay. Okay. Again, see, this is based on randomness. Okay. So you can see you will have a different kind of questions every time when you press this. Okay, write a program to demonstrate. So you can also see your name also. Yes, a student. I just clicked. See, like this, you have to click on the specific names. So you are going to get a question. Okay, so what you have to do is, so you have to write it on a sheet of paper. Or if you have a laptops, okay, you can write a code and you have to run that program, okay, along with an output. You have to send it to me through an application. Okay, so I have designed an application for where you will have user form. So where you are going to give your name, your USN number, your mobile number, and there will be 2 uploads. Okay, one upload, it should be in a PDF format only to upload your program. Okay, and the second upload will be to upload the Viva questions. Okay, so when you are clicking on your name, okay, so you have to make a note of this program. Okay, you have to take a note of this program. Anyway, in my application, against the student name, there will be a program name also, okay, for me to cross validate. Okay, so you have to make down this, make a note of this, okay, and you have to write a program. Okay, that's one thing. Second thing is, okay, so here one more small program, okay, where once you submit that, clicking on your against your name, you are going to get a question number. And when you're clicking against your this thing program, okay, so you are going to get 3 questions. So Viva question asked for students, so question 2, question 5, question 5. Okay, so since this is a random number, again and again it is the same number, there is a possibility of coming. Okay, so you can see here. Okay, so 155 like this, it keeps coming. Okay, so I will just try to modify and validate it properly. So you have to take a screenshot of this. Okay, so in your Word document, you have to type the question. You'll get a complete question and write the answers and submit it to me through that application. So you'll be given a time of say 3 hours. Okay, you'll be given a time of say 3 hours. Within 3 hours, okay, you have to write a program. You have to write a program, okay, and you have to write showcase the output also. Okay, that has to be uploaded. And second is 3 Viva questions. Okay, so you have to write that Viva questions. Okay, and upload even that and click on a submit, but I will show you that application at a later point of time. Okay, still it has to be ready. There's some small error which is coming. Okay, so that needs to be done. So once you do that, within all these things you have to do within 3 hours. Okay, so those who are having laptops, you can just run this program and showcase my output. And if you are not having a laptop, or if you are using only mobiles for all these things, so you can write a program and the output along with the Viva, okay, in a sheet of paper. Okay, so scan it. Please convert it into PDF and upload through that application. Okay, so you have to make sure that you have to be available for complete 3 hours online. Okay. Okay, so in this, do you have any clarifications? Anybody? If you have any difficulties, please let me know. Okay. Others? Is it clear to all of you, Aditya, Chetana, Surya? Okay. Seema? Vishal? Okay. If you are okay, we'll be having lab exams on Monday. Okay, except second program and ninth program, all other programs will be there. Okay, so if you have any difficulties, please let me know. Okay, if you don't have anything, I will just wind it up. So thank you. I hope all of you are prepared for tomorrow's test. Okay, so it will be quite simple. I'm sure that everybody can get very good marks. Okay, I will see to it at a later point of time. Okay, so have any difficulties?